Biggest gap here. It's an epic adventure that my partner Laura and I decided to tackle a couple of years ago. The challenge? 365 activities in 365 days all around New Zealand. You're joining us for day 101, and today we're going to go check out the Bearded Miners of Riften. It's a historical area in which you can talk to old bearded miners, and they will tell you about the, well, mining era of Riften.
It's day 101 of our 365 days of 365 activities, and today's priority is the Bearded Miners. And what a priority it is. The Bearded Miners are situated in Riften, and it's a place where you can learn more about the gold mining history of the area in a really unique way.
It only cost a few gold coin donation for us to be able to spend up to half an hour with one of the Bearded Miners. They are not comedians or actors. Those guys are actual miners that used to spend their time in the mineshaft in the area. They have heaps of souvenirs that they gathered during their mining times, including gold nuggets and heaps of jewels. It's really awesome, and they have a real insight in what used to happen back in the days. Our bearded miner is showing us heaps of stuff that we've never seen before, including gold, exactly as it is found in the wild in a mine. I've never seen that before. We also see vial and sapphire and even fool's gold, which used to trick miners back in the days, and people thought, oh my gosh, I just found heaps of gold, and that was just not gold. He's also explaining us how they extract all those minerals and how they detect them to find where there is more of them. It's fascinating. It's a whole industry that Laura and I never knew anything about.
This really is an example of raw New Zealand history, as if it was alive today. Talking with a guy who has spent decades in the mines is a really cool and original way to learn about this industry. And now he is teaching us the art of gold panning, which is actually a lot harder than it looks. There's a lot of skills, a lot of techniques, and a lot of patience when it comes to panning for a very little amount of gold. We can barely see the speck of gold that he managed to pan for after about 20 minutes of panning. Our time with Mr. Bearded Miner has come to an end, and we can't leave Riften without having one last hot chocolate and coffee from that coffee shop that we showed you yesterday on Broadway. And then we are going to be hitting the road towards Westport.
And the road that is going to take us from Riften to Westport is going through the mesmerizingly beautiful Buller Gorge. They are absolutely stunning. They are towering, thick, bushy mountains bathing in a massive wide river. It's absolutely amazing. I love this drive, if you can't tell by the tone of my voice. And soon enough, we arrive to the lovely township of Westport. This town right on the coast is one of the most iconic spots in the West Coast. It's really well known for its surf, but soon enough, as soon as we check in the Basil Hostel, where we're going to be staying for our Westport exploration, we learn that it's also an awesome spot to mountain bike. So our host there give us some mountain bike and send us on our way, because we still have some daylight and they want to keep us busy.
We are hitting the Kawatiri bike trails, which is a whole network of mountain biking trails going through forest and lining the north beach of Westport. Most of the trails here at the Kawatiri Beach Reserve are super well maintained with gravel, but somehow we do end up going off course a little bit into the muddy four-wheel drive tracks that we have no idea how we got here.
We find our way back toward the track pretty easily. There is heaps of signs around, and it's very easy to make our way back toward where we came from. We are heading back toward the hostel. This was just a quick mountain biking trip, nothing really fancy. We just wanted to check out those areas so we can write about it for you guys on backpackerguide.nz. We will spend the evening in the hostel chatting with our host. They are really super sweet and relaxed people. They're all about surfing, and they're talking us into joining them for a surf in the next few days. So we're gonna keep an eye on the forecast, and soon we will be surfing. Today is day 101. I can't believe we already passed 100 days. I could not believe that in day 99. I could not believe that in day 100. And yet today, guess what? I can't believe it either. What? Crazy, right? All things don't change, as say the proverb from Chinese origins.
Alright guys, so this video really encapsulates the West Coast history of New Zealand. Mining, and especially gold mining, has been part of the West Coast culture for decades now. And since then it also became a tourist attraction, since a lot of mine shafts and everything have closed. And there is really a rich history. I mean, it was really cool to hear from those guys. They look the part, they sound the part, they know everything, you know. It's not just a tour guide, it's really some people that genuinely were working in the mines. We didn't have much comments on this video, and usually at this time of the video I'm going over the comment that we had, and we literally just had a comment from Samantha that was saying, hey, I live here. So here you go. That was the only comment on that video. I think it's one of the hidden gems of New Zealand, and that's why a lot of people don't search for it, and therefore this video has not been found a lot. But I do like to show you guys something which are completely out of the ordinary, and we do like with Laura doing those kind of things. That's kind of our specialty. And that's why we actually started writing nzpocketguide.com, which is New Zealand's largest travel guide. We really wanted to make sure that you guys had access to a ton of different activities that most people never heard of when planning their trip to New Zealand. It may not be your thing, but at least, here you go, you have access to those. So you can check out nzpocketguide.com. It's the largest travel guide to New Zealand. It's all free to use, and it's written by Laura and I, so you actually know that you will have access to everything that there is to do in New Zealand, which is quite cool. If you do want to actually chat with us and communicate with us and ask us to kind of like proof your itinerary, give you some extra tips and everything, that's no problem at all. We do that every single week at 8 a.m. on Sunday New Zealand time. We sit on that couch over there and we do a live session. That means that you can come and ask us all your questions you want in the live chat, and we'll be happy to answer the questions for you. And if you can't make it, feel free to put your questions in the comment of this video. We go over comments quite regularly to give you some insights and help you plan your trip to New Zealand. In the meantime, if you do find those videos useful, and if you do want to see more hidden gems of New Zealand and keep on following New Zealand's biggest gap year, there is a good 264 more videos to come. So you may want to hit the subscribe button. It's a free way to say thank you for all our hard work. And if you want to do a little less, you can just hit click the like button. It's another free way to say thank you for all the hard work. In the meantime, thank you for joining us for this awesome video. Keep being an awesome person. Keep browsing the internet. There's a lot of fun things to find there. And we'll see you later. Bye-bye.